So, welcome, 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 welcome to my channel. This is KG, my life, my MF journey, okay? I ain't been on in a minute, but I'm back, bitch. So, everybody and their mama and their grandmama and their great-grandmama should be toasting today. Because what? We have sent him packing, finally. Evel, or Evelina, whatever you want to call Dumpster, Donald Dumpster, he's gone. He's out. I think he's got like 79 more days left, if that, something like that, like 70-something days left before it's over for him. Listen, I want to say thank you to everybody who came out, who voted, who came out in like big, giant crowds just voting. You brought your grandmama out in her wheelchair. You brought your uncle out with his cane. You know what I'm saying? You brought your handicapped sister, your handicapped brother. Y'all brought y'all family. We came in big numbers to get him out of there because we all knew that it wasn't right. If you notice, Biden led by ridiculous numbers. So that just shows you that America was done with the hate. Hate has no home here. Hate has no home here. And Donald Dump had to go. I'm sorry. He had to go. Ruining it, all the, like he's turning everybody against each other. The world was so tensioned. You have no idea. There's such a sense of relief that has come over millions of people right now, including myself, about this man getting out of the house. Hi. Out of the big house. Hi, this is KG, my life, my journey. Welcome to my channel. Come on in. Come on in, girl. Come on in, sir. Sit down over here. Let me talk to you for a minute. Okay, so as you know, President-elect and Vice President-elect, of course, it's Biden and Kamala Harris. I'm very, very proud of Kamala Harris. Now, a lot of people have, some people have different emotions about her. I don't give a damn. Let me tell you something. This woman had a job to do when she was a DA. She earned her stripes. She had a job to do and she did it quite well. Okay? What were you expecting her to do? Not to do her job? She did her job. So whoever the fuck she locked up, she had to lock them up for committing crimes. Do people change in their views on the world or society or people as a whole change when they get older or when times are changing? Yes, of course. I'm sure some of the views that she's had, and I've listened to the way she was when she was on her campaign run, I would listen to her, some of her views and the way she spoke about her life as a DA and everything else, and I believe that she's changed a bit. Of course she has. She's working with Biden. She's going to have to change a little bit. Now, they were not initially my picks, but they're here. Liz, can we say first woman vice president? Can we say first black and Asian black woman of color as vice president? That is big. That is huge. That shows you that no matter how much hate there is here in the world, that the world is changing, that people are changing. This is the way it's supposed to be. You know what I'm saying? So now she's bringing in hope for a lot of little black and brown girls. Now, if they know that they can achieve this status, you know what I mean? And more, that they could become even president one day. I'd love to see that. I won't be around to see it probably. But, you know, I mean, come on. The way the society is now, I mean, we have a long way to go before they, you know, drop their nuts and let a woman become president. Really. Anywho. Child. So, was in Columbus Circle today and had a good old time. I wanted to celebrate, like I was celebrating with people that I didn't even know, but they're my friends because they were there to celebrate. Of course you had the opposers on the other end, the haters, the ones that are mad, the dumpsters. They were furious. They were actually there to do what? Like what? It's over. why are you here? If you're not supporting this man, then why are you here? So, cops everywhere, of course. Interesting, just to say that, to say the least. So, I didn't stay long, stayed for a little while. I was concerned because, you know, there's been protests, violent protests, all over the U.S. actually, lately, and in New York especially, you know, all the stores, they are all boarded up and everything because people were afraid of what's going to happen. They were waiting for today to see what today was going to bring. So the stores are still boarded up, and the protesters are still out there, and so are the cops. And some of these same cops that were murdering people of color and getting away with it are out there as well. So I thought it was just best to go support, as he called him, Sleepy Joe. Well, Sleepy Joe won, bitch. Sleepy Joe won. And I knew he would. There was not even a doubt in my mind Joe was going to win. Was not going to win. You know what I mean? It was not a joy. And he's got a smart, smart, educated woman on his side, Miss Kamala Harris. Very smart, very educated. So I'm really proud. This makes me proud. This makes me proud for the black and brown people. So I left. I didn't want to drink or anything, so I went to wait until I get home. Because the bitch wanted to drink, which I wanted to shower. Get home, shower. You know, most of the people out there are wearing the masks, but then there are a lot of them that aren't. But most of them are. I would say most of them are. But still, when I come from the city, I usually feel very coronified. Like, I feel like I got corona all over me, so I just have to take a shower. Like, ASAP. So, took a shower, changed or whatever, and washed the corona off of me, child. And poured myself a cocktail, because I don't drink. I don't drink outside, and there's a reason for that. That goes back to my trauma, of course, you know, experiences in life, things that I've been through, situations that I might have put myself in, due to other situations. So, things that happened, or that happened to me, things that happened to me, basically. In a way, traumatized me. So I don't trust people. I just don't. Not easily. It takes a lot for me to trust you. Like a lot, a real lot. a real lot. But going out casually and having fun, I can do that all day long. We can drink until the sun comes up, baby. But drinking in public. And in the current climate right now, what's going on with everything, it's probably not a wise decision to be around a bunch of people that you don't know, especially when you got Trump supporters still out there, you know, yelling and screaming and booing and acting stupid. Then you got the cops who are probably on the dumpsters side, you know. So the best thing for me to do, I've protested a lot over the summer. I marched, I protested until my feet literally had blisters on them. So I know what that's like, to see the hard work pay off and to celebrate, you know what I mean? So I enjoyed myself. It was like, this is the reward for all this sweating and hot in the middle of a pandemic. I could have easily caught corona or something, you know? I didn't, thank God, but I could have, you know what I mean? I was in the middle of everybody. I was on the front lines, literally, in some of the protests. So, I'm just really happy and in a good, good place. I'm glad this happened. It was something else I came on here to talk about, but I think I forgot. I know I left off, 501c3. So, 501c3 is a form that I need to have filled out, but it's more than just a form. There's several forms that I'm now learning. There's about six. Okay, there's two ways I could do it. From the research that I've been doing, I had to research this on my own. pull up everything on my own. I don't know where my board member is or what is going on, but my board member never gave it back to me with any type of information, and it's been a few days now. And so I've done my own research, of course. It's my baby. It's going to be my organization. So I expect to do most of the work anyway. So I'm going to give him a break on that. However, upon doing my research, there's two ways to actually do it. One is be informed enough. Not necessarily smart enough, but informed enough about a 501c3 to be able to do the six steps that there are to do, so you can do it on your own, right? It's a lot of paperwork and a lot of just back and forth, a lot of stuff to do if you're doing it on your own. Or number two, I could pay someone, a professional, to do it for me. Yeah. And then I ain't gotta worry about shit. Sign some forms, get everything done professionally. It could cost anywhere from $50 to $150 to $1,700, which is still not a lot of money when you think about the investment that you're making for your organization in the long run. You know, this, you know, child, it's gonna be nonprofit and everything, but there's a lot that comes with a nonprofit business. And besides, you know, yeah, I have to do it. I have to get it registered. And I'm so ready for this. Y'all have no idea. So I did my research, and that's what I've been doing for the past few days, and that's why you guys haven't heard from me, because I've been studying. I've been studying my ass off. I've been researching. I've been Googling. I've been YouTubing. I've been making actual phone calls, and speaking to professionals about it. So now I just need to start making the steps, and that's coming up real soon. But you know, I still have a lot more work to do, you guys. I have a lot more work to do. I'm very proud of myself. Of course, you know, I hope y'all went and checked out my article that I was in Blackout Magazine. You know, Blackout Magazine. You know, I'm gonna brag about it. Blackout Magazine interviewed me about Kijin's Outreach for the Homeless. So you guys go check it out. It's an online magazine, and the article, the column, and the interviewer's name is Britton Hodges. A very good looking black man, okay, of trans experience. He fine. But I don't tell him that he's fine. Because I don't tell men that. Because I don't want it to go to their heads. But no, I would definitely tell him that. I've told him that already. But he interviewed me. Look at me. I hate when I blush. Anywho. Britton Hodges did an interview on me from Blackout Magazine. He also has a support organization, foundation for trans men. It's called Next Generation of Men, I think. Don't quote me. But yeah, anyway, go to Blackout Magazine, and when you click on the link of his name, Britton Hodges, and everything about him is going to be on his public figure page. Also, click on my page at Cajun's Outreach for the Homeless, or KKKAYKAY Brassfield, BRASSFIELD. Hercules. So, I will see you guys on Wednesday. But I'm going to see you again before Wednesday. I'm going to come back tomorrow probably. If not tomorrow, it'll definitely be this week. Definitely going to be on Wednesday. I'm going to try to get two videos in on Wednesday because I have something else special coming up and I need to go for this consultation. Yeah, so I'll make sure I film it. Don't worry. I love you guys. Thank you for watching. I love you so much. I'm in a really good mood. Y'all have yourselves. If you drink, please have a cocktail. If you don't drink and you smoke weed, bitch, light a blunt. Okay? And by the way, you know, for the people that think that trans women aren't going to be, aren't anything but hookers or which, by the way, it's basic in this world and this society that we live in presently at this moment, it's get it how you live. So if a girl got to sell whatever she got to sell to get a coin to support herself, I completely and wholeheartedly back her up on it. What? Fight me. I 100% back her up on it because that may be her only way of doing things at the moment. And so I don't judge. Period. She's got to support herself. She got to eat. She got to survive. Or he. You know, it could be a man or a woman. Who knows? There's a lot of men doing the same thing. But let me get back on track what I was saying. A lot of girls, a lot of people, cisgender and otherwise, you know, they stereotype us. Trans women, black trans women especially, and they say that we're all hookers and that we are will never be taken seriously and no one. You know how many of us are leaders in the community now? Do you know how many of us are actors and lawyers and surgeons? Doctors. Yeah. We're all over. We're doing the damn thing, you know what I'm saying? And I'm very proud. I'm very proud. The longer I'm here in New York, the more I'm, getting the opportunity to meet other leaders in the LGBTQ community, and I'm very proud of them, you know, and the work and that they've done and that they're doing right now. So, you know, but you want to make sure when you go looking for resources from them, that you get with the right ones. Like any other human being in the world, there's the good ones and then there's the bad ones. Okay, so you definitely want to get with the ones that's going to support you and actually that you can prove, that you can see, that you've done your research and you see they're actually doing the work. And they're not just, you know, photo opping and getting awards like Donald Trump. Yeah. But not really doing the work. Yeah. So, anywho. So I'm very proud of myself. I'm also proud that I've already started leaving my legacy now behind you guys. This is mine. My legacy. I can say that you cannot take that away from me. Wow. It took a while for me to find my niche. I always knew what it would always be in the realm of helping people to help themselves. It was always going to be that, you know, particular area. I just didn't know which route I wanted to go, you know, because I'm a well-rounded girl, honey. I have modeled in my past. Hair magazines, the internet, professionally, not on the big levels though, let's just, you know, nothing like that, but I've been in a hair magazine, I've done a lot of stuff, I've always wanted to act, like, I'm a well-rounded girl, and there's things that I always wanted to do. I think sometimes I'm mad at myself because I waited so long to find my niche, to find what really works for me. But, you know, I have to stop beating myself up because I found it. No matter how long it took, I found it. This is my legacy. This is something that's in my name that I'm leaving behind. So my name will be remembered. As a matter of fact, you can Google me now. Google me. Google Kejean's outreach for the homeless. Google Kejean, K-E-G-I-N-E. To see my work. You're going to find my work. So I love you. And have a drink, bitch. Smoke a joint. Smoke a blunt. Relax. Chill. Don't do no hard drugs. And take care of yourself. Love yourself. Love other people. Share love. Stay safe. And I'll be back tomorrow. Love y'all.